Yeah, guys, when the president said he would use whatever power his office holds to prevent this type of violence, a lot of people were left wondering what that meant exactly. But at more than one point last night, he also said some things that seemed to strike squarely on the Second Amendment.
Are we prepared to say that such violence visited on our children year after year after year is somehow the price of our freedom?
The president never said gun control, but most understood the message.
I don't think there's any question, Josh, that it's a discussion that must take place.
A former Marine, Manchester Senator Lou D'Alessandro, is no stranger to guns, but he believes it's time to at least revisit the idea of the legal sale of assault-style weapons.
What are you going to hunt? You're going to hunt people. And that's been the case time after time after time.
This is the world we live in. And you can't stop crazy people. You can take away their guns, but they're going to use knives.
Attorney Penny Dean is with Gun Owners of New Hampshire. Now, while she shares the outrage of what occurred in Connecticut, she says the argument is misplaced.
There's case after case after case of armed citizens stopping this carnage. And why aren't we protecting our children? Why aren't we having our teachers have the ability to protect our children? Why aren't administrators doing that?
Clearly, the emotions right now are raw, and it is a debate with two very different sides with no easy answers.
It's a horrible thing that happened, and I mean, there's nothing you can do to reverse it.
It's in everybody's best interest, not just the people who are anti-gun or pro-gun. Everybody needs to consider what it is.
Well, this issue could very well be a central one this year in Washington. Today, California Senator Dianne Feinstein, in fact, vowed to back legislation that would again place a federal ban on assault-style weapons. Last one, by the way, expired back in 2004. Reporting live, Josh McElwain, WMUR News 9.